Drones have become an indispensable tool of modern life, and although they're being adopted to do things like deliver packages, they're mainly seen through the work they do the most, carrying cameras into otherwise inaccessible areas. Here at the Weather Channel, drones give us the ability to show you the power of nature, like the destructive flooding that we saw in Michigan earlier this week. They've become a new tool in viewing and understanding natural disasters. But instead of natural disasters, one group is using drones to create nature. Joining us now from Spain is the founder of Dronecoria, Lot Amoros. Good afternoon to you there. Thanks for joining us. Tell us what advantages drones have over more traditional methods of planting forests.
Hi, thank you for the invitation. So the best is that they can cover huge areas in a few time, and also they are very cheap to drop seeds. If we compare with traditional planting methods, they are able to plant more than 200 hectares in only one day, so they are very fast.
That's a lot in one day. So can you speak to how much land you've been able to seed since you began the project?
Yeah, actually, we are running a pilot test in Spain. So we are running different kinds of seed coatings and different kinds of trees, species. So right now, we are focusing in the experimentation. And we will take the best experiments to replicate and expand the reforestation in Spain.
And how many of these drones are you using?
Yeah, actually, we have three drones, but normally we use only one in one operation. We planning to use two at the same time in a project in Kenya next year.
I see. I mean, they're pretty large drones, too. I understand they can probably carry a lot of weight. And how does this help the planet?
Yeah, unfortunately, with the climate change, we are losing a lot of trees, also with illegal logging. So they are helping the planet because we can cover big areas, we can plant a lot of trees in only one day, and to fight against fast floods or any kind of problems related with climate change, we can cover big areas in a few times. No? So this is the most important, to capture the maximum quantity of CO2.
And Lon, I've never seen a drone look like that. It's pretty cool looking. So it's created, you know, it's much more than an aerial camera mount, too. Tell us what's unique and special about it.
Yeah, I mean, these drones are designed to have a heavy lift, so they carry 10 kilos. They are quite big, like 1.5 meter. And especially our drones are made in wood because it's easy to cut and are very cheap, because we are focusing in via teach providers. So we create these drones for environmental organizations around the world. So we try to make drones that organizations can easily replicate and can easily repair. So this is why they are made in wood.
And the drone isn't just dropping seeds, right? Tell us how you prepare the bundles you drop so they'll have a better chance of survival.
Yeah, actually, we speak a lot about drones, but the magic is around the seeds, especially the seed coating, because when you drop a seed in a surface, they have a few opportunities to survive. So adding different layers of biochar, microorganisms, clay, and different elements improve a lot the efficiency for the survival of the seed.
And what's interesting is your project is actually open source, which means anyone can use it. So what kind of response have you gotten so far?
Yeah, actually, the problem around this technology is normally is closed, so there is a lack of information, a lack of open experimentation. So it's like kind of a open science to partner with different universities around the world. Thanks to this, we have different partners, like in Brazil, the University of Mato Grosso, and other environmental associations around the world. So it's a way to understand the ecosystems better and share information between partners. So actually, our project had a lot of acceptance and a lot of people contacted with us around the world.
Very cool, and educational at the same time. We're learning a lot from these drones. Thank you so much, Lot Amoros, founder of Dronecoria. We appreciate your time joining us all the way from Spain today. So thank you so much for that. Reynolds, my son actually got a drone. He's got a